So we're starting with unit 9 today, hydrogen. Now hydrogen, you know that is the first member of the periodic table with atomic number Z that is equal to 1. Now because of its atomic number Z equal to 1, it is also known as the simplest kind of element which is going to be present, and with the simplest kind of electronic configuration which is going to be 1s1. Due to the electronic configuration of hydrogen, it is seen that it has similarities with both alkali metals and with halogens, right? So as a result of that, when Mendeleev gave his periodic table, you've already studied, and when the long form periodic table that was also discussed, the position of hydrogen, that was always controversial. As if now also, when we're talking of position of hydrogen, it is controversial. That is the reason why it was given a separate group. It was not either placed under the alkali metals nor under the halogens because of its certain similarities and certain differences between both the groups, that is the alkali metals and the halogens. So it was placed in a separate, in the first period, with helium. Okay, so let's discuss a little about hydrogen, its history, and how the position of hydrogen that was controversial or that was complicated. Okay, now when we're talking of hydrogen, I've already told you that hydrogen, that is the lightest element known. Okay, it is the lightest amongst all the elements of the periodic table, and it is the most abundant element of the universe. It is going to be the most abundant element of the universe. Now over here, it comprises nearly 90%. It comprises 90% of all atoms, right? So whether we're talking of hydrocarbons or we are talking of any kind of acids, we are talking of water. So all of them, they're going to have hydrogen as one of the component. So it is the most abundant element of the universe, and it is a major component of all compounds after oxygen and silicon. Oxygen is the most abundant, silicon is the second most abundant, and then comes hydrogen, which is going to be the third most abundant element over here. Now it is the first member of the periodic table with Z is equal to 1, so it has a very simple electronic configuration of 1s1 over here. Now hydrogen, you know that it is, it is found in the sun due to many fission reactions which are taking place in the sun. So it is also a major component of the universe and the sun both. Now hydrogen can be very can be prepared by the combination of atomic oxygen, where the delta H over here, that is going to be -436.4 kilojoules per mole. Okay. Now over here we also call hydrogen as a clean fuel. Why it is known as a clean fuel? Because the oxidation of it, when we are burning it, the oxidation of it is going to produce water. Okay, so that is the reason why it is known as a clean fuel. Now there are many organic compounds in which hydrogen is present as one of the component. For example, if you're taking carbohydrates, or we are taking hydrocarbons, or we are taking proteins. So most of the organic compounds, it has hydrogen as one of its important one of its important components. Now when we're talking of hydrogen's position, in the periodic table, the configuration of hydrogen, that is going to be 1s1. So this configuration that is responsible for dual nature of hydrogen, that is, it can behave as both alkali metals as well as hydrogen, as well as halogens. Okay, because of its this electronic configuration. So because it has a tendency either to lose this one electron or it has a tendency to gain this one electron. Therefore, the position of hydrogen in the periodic table, that is not going to be fixed. Sometimes it is placed with the alkali metals. Sometimes it is also placed with the halogens. Sometimes it can behave as an electropositive element, and sometimes it also behaves as an electronegative element. Okay. So let's go on to first of all the similarities and differences between alkali metals and hydrogens. That will become or that will make the study of hydrogen much easier. Okay. So let's go on to the similarities with alkali metals. Now when we are doing the similarities with alkali metals, the first similarity is the electronic configuration. Okay, so when we are looking at the electronic configuration of hydrogen, the electronic configuration is 1s1. Similarly, when we are looking at the electronic configuration of lithium, the electronic configuration of in the outermost shell, that is going to be 2s1. Or we are looking at the electronic configuration of sodium, the electronic configuration, that is going to be 3s1. So it has one electron in the outermost shell, just like all the other alkali metals. Therefore, it is going to have an electropositive character. The second similarity is its tendency to lose this one electron to enter into an electropositive state. So similarly, we know that lithium also has a tendency to lose one electron and exist as Li positive. And sodium has a tendency to lose one electron and become Na positive. Okay? So it has a electropositive character. Now because of this electropositive character over here, during electrolysis of say you're doing the electrolysis of water or you're doing the electrolysis of acidulated water. So during electrolysis, hydrogen is discharged at the cathode, just like the alkali metals, right? So it has, therefore it is going to have the same characteristics, that is the electronic configuration, electropositive character is similar to that of the alkali metals. The third is going to be the valency. We know that the valency of alkali metals, that is equal to +1, right? Because it has a tendency to lose one electron. So the valency you can see over here, lithium positive, sodium positive, it is going to have a valency of +1. Similarly, hydrogen also exhibits a valency of +1. Okay? It is also going to exhibit a valency of +1. Then, just like halogens, just like alkali metals, hydrogen also has affinity for halogens. Halogens are highly electronegative elements. So it has affinity or affinity with halogens. Jaise for example, we have halogens ki jagah you can also write it has affinity for non-metals. Because halogens, they are non-metals. Right? So like for example, if you're talking of HCl, lithium forms in a similar manner, LiCl, sodium forms in a similar manner, NaCl, then another electronegative element we can take is water, ठीक है. सो ये बनाता है H2O, लिथियम इज गोइंग टू मेक Li2O, सोडियम इज गोइंग टू मेक Na2O, राइट. सिमिलरली दिस हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू बॉन्ड विद सल्फाइड, सो H2S, Li2S एंड Na2S. सो दिस अगेन शोज अ सिमिलैरिटी विद द अल्कली मेटल्स. सो जस्ट लाइक अल्कली मेटल्स, हाइड्रोजन ऑल्सो हैज reducing nature. ठीक है, it has a tendency to reduce. For example, if we take CuO plus H2, it is going to extract the oxygen from here and reduce copper oxide to copper. ठीक है, the same tendency is also shown by sodium. So this is going to give us again Cu plus Na2O. So this is another similarity over here. Then what are the differences? When we're talking of differences with alkali metals, differences with alkali metals, the first difference is the difference in energy. ठीक है, so over here ionization energy of hydrogen is going to be very very high. So we're talking of ionization energy of hydrogen, that is 1312 kilojoules per mole, right? And that of lithium, when we're talking, it is only 520, and sodium still has lower, which is 495. So there is a marked difference between ionization energy of hydrogen and the alkali metals. The second one is that hydrogen that has a non-metallic character whereas all the alkali metals they are going to be metallic in nature. ठीक है, so we have hydrogen as non-metallic, whereas rest all the alkali metals they are going to be metallic. Then number three, there is a difference in atomicity. For example, hydrogen exists as diatomic, but all the alkali metals they are going to exist as monoatomic. ठीक है, they are going to exist as monoatomic. फिर उसके बाद हमारे पास आता है nature of oxide. When we talking of nature of oxides, the oxide of hydrogen, that is water, that is going to be neutral in nature. Whereas the oxides of alkali metals, they are basic in nature. Right? So they all are going to be basic in nature. Then when we're talking of compounds of hydrogen, the compounds of hydrogen are low boiling especially when we're talking of compounds of hydrogen with halogens, it forms HF, it forms HCl, it forms HBr. All of these, they are going to be low boiling, covalent compounds. Low boiling covalent compounds. Whereas when we're talking of halides of, alkali metals, like we have lithium chloride, we have NaCl, we have KCl, all these they are going to be high melting ionic complexes. ठीक है, so these are the differences of hydrogen. Similarities with halogens. The first similarity is going to be the non-metallic character. Both halogens as well as hydrogen, they are going to be non-metallic. Okay? Then number two, electronic configuration. When we're talking of electronic configuration over here, or as hydrogen has one electron less to the nearest noble gas helium, in a similar manner, the next are also going to have one electron less. For example, halogens mein humne fluorine le rahe hain, the ion, this electronic configuration is 2s2 2p5, right? And when we're talking of neon, the nearest noble gas over here, it will have only one electron less. So it will have electronic configuration of 1s2 2s2 2p6, right? Similarly, when we go to chlorine, neon, 3s2 3p6, it has one electron less to the nearest noble gas, which is argon. 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3p6. So this is one of the similarities between the halogens and hydrogen. Then number three, atomicity. When we are talking of, both have diatomic nature, right? Like hydrogen exists as H2, fluorine will exist as F2, chlorine will exist as Cl2. So they are going to be diamagnetic. Then number four, hydrogen also shows electronegative nature just like halogens. That is, it has a tendency to gain one electron and give us hydride ion, H negative. Okay? Similarly, chlorine will also, it has a tendency to gain one electron and give us Cl negative ion. Right? And fluorine also has a tendency to gain one electron to give us F negative ion. So, it is going to be electronegative in nature. Because of its electronegative, in case of metal hydrides of the type MH, when we are doing the electrolysis of metal hydrides, the hydrogen that would be liberated at the anode, just like halogens. So hydrogen negative minus one electron to give us H, and H plus H to give us H2. The same is also happening with halogens. We have Cl negative minus one electron to give us Cl, Cl plus Cl to give us Cl2. Okay? So this is how there is going to be a similarity. Now when we are talking of ionization potential, ionization potential is comparable with those of all the halogens. When we are talking of ionization potential of hydrogen, we just said that it has around, in electron volt, it has around 13.5. पहले हमने किलो जूल्स में लिया था, ठीक है? So this is an electron volt. Fluorine has 17.5. Chlorine has 13. So chlorine का बहुत ही near है to hydrogen. Then bromine has 11.82. And iodine, that is going to have 10.43. So over here, the ionization potentials, they are quite near to each other. This is going to be another similarity. Then we have the next one. It forms same kind of bonds with, you can say, group 14 elements, right? So it forms similar compounds with group 14 elements. ठीक है, जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल कार्बन के साथ इट फॉर्म सी एच फोर एंड कार्बन फॉर्म्स द सेम काइंड ऑफ कंपाउंड विद क्लोरीन. ठीक है, विद सिलिकॉन इट फॉर्म्स साइलेंस एस आई एच फोर एंड विद क्लोरीन ऑल्सो इट फॉर्म्स द सेम राइट. And with geranium it forms GeH4 and the halogens also forms the same. Okay, then hydrogen and halogens, they are mutually replaceable. Replaceable. मतलब इसका क्या हुआ कि जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर डूइंग सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन एंड यू वॉन्ट टू रिप्लेस हाइड्रोजन विद क्लोरीन ओवर हियर, सो अगर हम क्लोरीन के साथ करेंगे वी आर गोइंग टू गेट CH3Cl, और इसको अगर हम रिवर्स रिएक्शन हाइड्रोजन के साथ करेंगे तो वी आर गोइंग टू गेट H, वी आर गोइंग टू गेट CH4. सो दे आर म्यूचुअली रिप्लेसेबल. देन वी कम टू ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट और नंबर.